on Railway Stakes not too long ago. So it's definitely nice enough trial form, and it's good to see Shake the Bloom went out today.
Certainly. And with Kira Yule on board in the hands of the gate attendant straight away. Abel Dane is the six, Arthur Mormeter and Christy Bennett claims two.
Well, he is a hard horse to catch, Abel Dane, but he is a previous winner off the 7-day backup. He's a horse that raced here 4 days ago on Saturday when he punctured really badly to be beaten 16 sluice box. Two starts ago, he was beaten six by Aragain in that race that we keep mentioning, but he was out in the middle of no man's land at one stage down the back straight. He was five deep, no cover in a staying race. So he's the kind of horse that this is the type of race Abel Dane would win.
Blazing Kazar is the seven, Chris Stelmack, Troy Turner.
We're looking at a horse here that's had 9 runs cumulatively on rain-affected tracks, has never won a race, has had 11 starts here at Belmont, has never run a placing, and yet goes around in single-figure odds. So it just goes to show, Britt, that these horses all get their chance in the midweek stayers. And Blazing Kazar's definitely going good enough to run a cheeky race.
Peri Peri Para is the eight, Keith Mithlin and Jason Whiting.
Had his first ever attempt last start at the staying trip at 2100, and he was caught up in that washing machine type effect mid-race where there were so many horses and riders making their moves at different stages. So I was happy enough to follow up with Peri Peri Para here and throw him into the quaddie, because today, if he gets a soft run leaders back or three back the fence and is saved for one last sprint at them, we might see a different horse.
And Taxi, the final runner for Bob McPherson and William Pike.
We go back two starts ago, finished third behind Crisaro. We've seen Crisaro win a Class 3 since, beating Aragain. Last night was beaten out of sight behind Darcel, but was left a long way behind them. A month between runs, Willie Pike takes over riding duties, and the punters have said that $15 is too much. They'll have a bit of that.
Yes, not often you see Willie Pike at $15, so I think a few punters say, we'll take some of that. All right, 3 minutes away from start time. How did you order the four for the stayers?
Awfully tough this, Brit, but I went 2, 3, 4, 6. I love the way that Darcel's gone about it her last two. I thought that two starts ago it was just one of those fluky heavy track wins, but she showed last start that was not the case. She was very, very good when finishing half a length behind Aragain. So in that race, she beat home Juliet by around 3 lengths and only meets her half a kilo worse. Same as Lollipop Lane. She beat her by 3 lengths and meets her only half a kilo worse here. So she should get an identical run in transit here. First two or three or four in running, getting a nice cart into it. And if she hits the front at the right time, she might simply outgrind them. 2, Darcel. 3, Lollipop Lane. If she finds the front after 200 metres, then this race will be hard to run her down in. Number 4, in Juliet, who will likely concede them both a head start, but has a nice, honest and consistent race pattern. And 6, Abel Dane. You just never know what you're going to get with Abel Dane, but he trims up late in betting, as he normally does on the quick backup. 2, 3, 4, 6.
It's quite remarkable, that stat that you said about Abel Dane on the quick backup in terms of the market, Scott. Today hasn't been quite as exaggerated, but we are seeing him firm into $17 off 4 days on this occasion. But gee, the betting move for him in the past has been quite pronounced when he's been off a quick turnaround.
Well, I'm sure there's still a number of people out there scratching their head trying to work out why he's 26 into 17, having been beaten 16 lengths only 4 days ago.
Yes, but the market does funny things, and that is often the case with Abel Dane, that he does firm in on the quick back up, but this market struggling to separate a couple of these top ones in the market. Lollipop Lane at 3:30, Darcel at 3:50. Here's Richie for the call of the stayers.
Now the field moving up for the staying race today. Coming forward. Now, up goes Abel Dane. Abel Dane goes up. Likes to work forward, off and down the back straight. A strange horse, getting fitter. Thanks, Matty. Matt McDermott joining us from the studios of Tab Radio today. And Blazing Kazar is moving forward with Taxi. Goes up for Willie Pike. Double figure odds. Shake the Bloom, who is a very difficult horse to get to the barriers. They worked hard on it. And Kira Yule was forced into a bit of a gallop up to the gates with the horse. But it's up there now. Lollipop Lane comes in for Ryan Hill. Blazing Kazar on the move. Standing up well, Bryce Road. Peri Peri Para, Jason Whiting in search of a double. Shot through to win on the inside with Nick of Time earlier on. Juliet moves forward in the pink and blue, and the red light is on. We're all set. Racing. Able Dame was actually a touch slow. Peri Peri Para got away well, doesn't want to be really leading, and Darcel takes it up and they're walking down the straight. Blazing Kazar, Ryan Hill has to pull the whip on Lollipop Lane to get him active. He's moving up now on the outside to come after the leaders, but Darcel's got the front. Lollipop Lane, Hill still pushing hard on the outside, three wide, just can't build up the speed to get to the lead. On the inside is Peri Peri Para. Blazing Kazar's back in the centre, and there's Abel Dane on the move early today. Bennett sends it around the outside. Shake the Blooms over on the inside of Juliet, travelling pretty well in the early stages. And then Taxi, and last of all is Bryce Road going into the back straight. Abel Dane makes the move out wide to race after Darcel's about to run to the front. Lollipop Lane got to third, fourth Peri Peri Para, and then Blazing Kazar as Abel Dane dashes to the lead down the back straight. Further back in the field, over on the outside is Juliet. Shake the Blooms on the inside, well back Taxi, and last of all the Bolt of Bryce Road, 11:50 from home, and it's Abel Dane out by 1 3/4. Lollipop Lane, Hill still niggling at it. On the inside is Darcel. Blazing Kazar fourth. Peri Peri Para's had a good run the inside. Likewise, Juliet in the moving line. Shake the Blooms down on the inside. The last two, Taxi and Willie Pike, and Bryce Road on the outside. Off the back straight they run, 900 from home. Abel Dane trying to recapture its best form. Leads by 1 1/4. Two, Lollipop Lane trying to close in, is doing that now. Darcel's on the inside. Blazing Kazar fourth. And then Peri Peri Para. Juliet still travels well. Shake the Bloom the inside, well back Bryce Road and Taxi. Around the turn they're about to run, 500 from home, and Lollipop Lane really putting it to Abel Dane and put the head in front. Blazing Kazar joined in. Darcel just behind them. Now Juliet gets to the outside, then Peri Peri Para, and further back Shake the Bloom, Bryce Road and Taxi struggling. Blazing Kazar has made a fast move on the outside and raced up to Lollipop Lane. Abel Dane back on the inside with Darcel in the centre, and further back in the field is Juliet trying to run on inside the 250. Blazing Kazar, he's way out in the centre, but he's nicely clear from Juliet, battling on Darcel, Lollipop Lane, and then Peri Peri Para, but it's Blazing Kazar made that dashing move at the 600, pull clear from Juliet, Peri Peri Para and Darcel, and Blazing Kazar. Blazing Kazar in the Stelmac colours has won from Juliet, Peri Peri Para, and close up for Darcel. Lollipop Lane was a difficult ride again for Hill, and then came Abel Dane, who weakened well back in the field. Shake the Bloom, Bryce Road and Taxi has pulled in a long last. Number seven is the winner, Blazing Kazar. 8:50. Troy Turner with a winning double after his win earlier on today on the Tricks of the Trade. And that's been a very good staying ride by Troy. He let the horse go, knows it's a bit one-paced, and he put it to them. He got past two horses who just couldn't build up any speed on the turn in Abel Dane and Lollipop Lane. Blazing Kazar just had that little bit of dash to get past them. And then forged clear. Juliet always travelled really well and let down quite nicely, but chased in vain. And Peri Peri Para kept sneaking runs up on the inside to run third. Darcel plugged home for fourth. And Lollipop Lane has battled into fifth place. Behind them was Abel Dane, who's probably getting closer, but still a fair way off winning form. So $8.50, $2 the winner. We'll head down to Brittany Taylor, who is no doubt having a chat with one of the Stelmacs.
I do have Jerry down here in the yard. And Jerry, it's always good when you have a big long drive, when you're able to come home with a winner. And I bet you it makes the drive home all the better.
It certainly is, Brittany. It's not as long as Northam.
You can go there tomorrow.
We're in the last race tomorrow, so hopefully it'll be a nice day for us.
But how long does it take you to get there?
3.5 hours. Just over 2 hours.
Feel like only 1.5 on the way home now that Blazing Kazar has got up. It's been 507 days. Were you, I dare say, were you confident coming into today, or as confident as you can be?
If you look at his last four or five runs, they've been okay, actually. His last start, they took him on, like, there was five across the track. And as I said to Troy, there's a bit of pace, get a sit, and, you know, he's well enough, and he's won, which is good.
What were you thinking during the run?
I was very happy where he was, especially the favourite outside, the leader, so he's going to get a good card up, but he went around him. It was a good staying. He's just an honest stayer, this bloke. So it was good effort. Well, I'm
really nice performance there. What's he like behind the scenes, this horse?
Nipper? He's like the owner, Trevor Parsons. He's a bit dumb, but he's a lovely horse.
I'm sure Trevor will love that description. A bit dumb, but lovely. I like that.
He's a great bloke.
Congratulations. Well done to you. There's Cherry Stelmack after the win of Blazing Kazar. And very honest horse, especially up around these staying journeys. And nice to see him salute today. It had been a little while since he's been in the winner's circle, but that is the case with a lot of these midweek staying types, Scott. They take turns, and today it was Blazing Kazar's turn. And Troy Turner about to weigh in. I'm wondering what our DJ in the truck is going to come up with a Blazing Kazar song.
Oh, maybe up there, Kazaley. That'll get Jerry Stelmack up and about, something like that to play in the background, Brittany. But this horse wins at his 12th attempt at Belmont Park, and today he's able to... Troy Turner's just given us the blind sight, and he's already off to go and celebrate. Jerry Stelmack does that to people, though. Troy, the other day, just taken on mid-race and again and again and again.
Yeah, well, I thought we're going in a pretty strong tempo. We seemed to have a few attacking quite early. And to his credit, he stuck on really good. Like, all the ones that were outside him sort of faded and ran near the tail, but he sort of boxed on, ran fifth. So he was in that race with a good chance today.
And he looked like he got a lovely run in behind the favourite as well.
Yeah, he did. He had a nice run, and he boxed it out strong. They ran to him, but he kept holding them off. So hopefully there's another one in him.
Congratulations. We'll let you go now.
There's Troy Turner and Jerry Stelmack. They combine with Blazing Kazar, taking out the Ascend Sales Trophies handicap.